You have rescued my life. You have rescued my life. And I'm never going back. My response is hallelujah. You're my redeemer. Hallelujah. It's your girl Naj, and I'm back with another video. So the snippet that y'all just heard was from Phil Thompson Worship. You know, scrolling through Instagram, and that song comes on. I'm like, okay, let's get into this worship. That's what inspired this video. Like, I just want to share just a few things about worship that I learned since my season of beginning to really press into the Lord. Okay, so the first thing that I learned is that worship is not just on Sundays. Like I just told y'all, it's a Thursday night. I just literally came from work and I'm parked, you know, in a parking spot, and a song came on, and immediately, you know, just a worship just broke out. And I just thank God for it, because I'm learning that worship is not just when you are in the physical building of the church. We are the church. So what I do in church on Sundays and when I go on Fridays, that's what's supposed to be going on in my house every single day. Like, I should be worshiping the Lord, praising him, thanking him, honoring him for everything that he's done, everything that he's doing right now, and everything that he's going to do, because he gets the glory, he gets the honor, and he gets all the what? All the praise, okay? Because he is due. I mean, the fact that I'm recording this, I'm winking, I'm blinking, like I have my whole life, my whole health, my whole piece of screen, okay? That is more reason to praise and worship the Lord. So again, remember, saints, we are the church. We don't have to wait till we get to the building in order to praise and worship the Lord, okay? And the other point that I learned about worship, that it is not about having the most melodious voice. That is something that I struggled with. And I have to say struggled, because that was in the past. Like, I thought, you know, when you worship the Lord, it's about how the riffs that you can do, how you can, you know, I don't know, what is it called? Like a vibrato or whatever you call it, how you can like modulate your voice up and down. That's great. If you can do that, if you've been blessed with that gift, that's awesome. But I've seen people who we look like, you know, people look at them like, oh, what they about to do? But they'll tear the whole house down, because it's the anointing that matters. Like, the gift is a blessing, but if you don't have the anointing attached to that gift, like, what strongholds are you going to be able to break? Like, it's only through Jesus. And I just thank God for that revelation, because y'all, like I said, I was, that was something that I struggled with. I could not get past, well, I don't sound like this one, and I don't sound like that one. I can't do this, wherever I can't. Listen, if it's meant for me to have it, I'll get it. I'll keep practicing. But in the meantime, I thank the Lord that I got the anointing on my life. I got the power of the Holy Ghost. So whatever it may not sound aesthetically correct to somebody else, the Lord hears my praise, okay? I also like to add the fact that I'm just thankful that I can come on here and share this part of my life with y'all and not feel ashamed and not feel like, ooh, they gonna be like, she can't sing. Listen, get into the worship. Like I said, I'm just thankful that that's growth. I'm past what people gonna think. I'm trying to get connected to the Lord, okay? Trying to get all up in the oneness with the commune, okay? Get it. And you know what's funny? Because I actually heard, I was listening to Chandler Moore on YouTube. And the preacher that was preaching was basically saying he doesn't invite entertainers to his church, because he just don't want people just to be, you know, singing, just to be singing with no anointing. And so I was just like, okay, Lord, that was brought back to my remembrance. Then also today I was meeting with my mom and another lady. Come to find out the lady is a praise and worship leader. So I'm like, okay, Lord, thank you for the revelation on this worship. Okay. And before I leave, I want y'all to get out your Bibles because I got a scripture for y'all. Okay. So we're gonna read Psalm 150, and the title is Let All Things Praise the Lord. Y'all ready? Y'all got your Bibles? Okay, praise the Lord, praise God in his sanctuary, praise him in his mighty firmament, praise him for his mighty acts, praise him according to his excellent greatness, praise him with the sound of the trumpet, praise him with the lute and harp, praise him with the timbrelet dance, praise him with string instruments and flutes, praise him with loud cymbals, praise him with clashing cymbals, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So that means I got breath. You breathing because you watching this video. So you got some breath, but this ring light ain't got no piece of breath. This chair that the ring light is leaning up against ain't got no breath. But you and I have breath. So we ought to do what? Praise and worship the Lord because he is so awesome. He's good. He's kind. He's merciful. And he's faithful. So that's all I got for y'all today. I thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you on the next video. Bye.